Hi guys, and welcome to this Bootstrap 4 Columns tutorial. This is Jamie from System22 and webdesignandtechtips.com. Well, in this video, we're going to explore the great new Bootstrap 4 column spacing classes and arrangement classes. With the new Bootstrap 4, we're going to explore some of the new auto layout columns that they've got going for us. By default, your columns usually align to the left, but you can align them at the start. You can align them center without having to do any offsetting. You can align them at the end. But also, if you've got multiple columns, you can put equal space between them. You can put equal space around them. And if you've got multiple columns, you can align the multiple columns to the end, to the middle, or to the start. And it really has made it easy for you. Of course, the offset class still works. If you've got one column and you want to offset it by 3, you can still use that. But you can do so much without having to do any of that offset classes. Let's explore it a little bit. Let's bring up my code editor here. I'm using the free brackets code editor. It's absolutely awesome. I'll put a download link below if anybody needs to use it. I would recommend it. It really is good. And plus it's free, of course. Okay, so that's our little column of one section there. The Bootstrap column is made up of 12, as we explained before. So 12 of those would make up a full span. If you did a column of 2, it'd be 6, etc. 4 would be 3. 3 would be 4. I'll shut up now because that's starting to get confusing, but I'm sure you understand. So I'm going to work on this little single column that we got going on here, which is here. So I'm going to copy it over a couple of times. Just 3 times, I suppose. And what I'm going to do, I'll put a bit of space below it. I've got a little spacer class that I made here with some CSS. I'll just put that below it so that we can make it stand out a little bit. Now I save that back to the site. Now when I refresh, we should have 3 little columns there. There we go, and there's a bit of space in between so we can see what we're doing. We're working on this right here. So we've got 3 single columns right there. Now we can justify those at the start, which is the default, so we don't actually have to do anything. We can put them in the middle. See, I've actually got those justify content start, which is the default. If I was to take that away, they'd still be there. Well, let's just do that, just to prove a point. So now if we go back to the site and refresh, those will stay exactly where they are, because that's the sort of default to align to the left. So let's push them to the middle. And I'll just paste that back in there. All I've got to do is change that start to center. And we'll go back, just saved it. Now when I refresh, this should appear in the middle right here. There we go. Before, you'd have to do an offset or make some auto margins of some sort. This makes it so easy. And of course, if we want it to the right hand side, we can justify it to the end, justify content to the end. Quick save and back to the site. So that's pretty cool right there, but it goes a step further. And you don't have to have these with similar size columns. Let's just change the size of the columns. Let's make that middle one, say a 3. No particular reason. We're working on these right here. So now that middle one's a 3. suppose I better change that to a 3-2. 3-2-1. It's getting very confusing. There we go. So you've got a column of 3 in the middle and a column 1 on the left and right. Now we can take it a step further. If I was to put justify content between here, it's going to put equal space between all of those columns. Let's save that, Control S, and back to the site. Now when I refresh, it's going to put equal space between all of these columns. They'll no longer be justified to the, well, they'll be spread out equally along the whole span there. So let's refresh. There we go. So let's put equal space in between these three columns. Like I say, it doesn't matter if you've got different size columns everywhere, it makes no difference. Now that's pretty cool. But you can also do it so you've got equal space around each one, which means they'll be sort of justified like they are in Photoshop when you justify the centers. I'll just do that. So if we change that between to around and save it, back to the site. Now when I refresh, these won't be at the ends right there. They'll kind of be in the middle, but with equal space around them. I mean, that's pretty cool to me. And it doesn't matter how many columns you've got going on, it'll do the same thing. So let's change it so we've got three different size columns there. And see what happens there. Let's make this last one, let's say a 4. Like I say, you used to have to do this with column offsets or margins or padding. Now this new Bootstrap 4 class has made it so easy. There we go. It's done exactly the same thing. It's put equal amount of space in between, start between each one, and it's justified the content in the middle of the page there. And again, if I change that to between, want to save it, Control S, back to the site. Now these two will be at the end, this one will be in the middle. So how cool is that? Thank you, Bootstrap 4, you've done a great job there. But like I say, Bootstrap 4 just keeps getting, or Bootstrap itself just keeps getting better and better. I use it all the time. If I'm not building an e-commerce store or a blog, I'll run to Bootstrap every single time because it's just so easy and it's quick loading. And I really enjoy working with it. So there we are. There's a brief summary of what you can do with the new auto layout columns with Bootstrap 4. I hope you found that useful. If you have, please like, share, and subscribe to our channel. If you're interested in web development, take one of our courses below. We've got some huge discounts for our YouTube subscribers. We've also got some great free courses down there, so check it out. Once again, this has been Jamie from System22 and webdesignandtechtips.com. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.